seems to be de facto falling to the one spec I did not really want to play. This time around, though, I'm like, there's nothing I haven't really enjoyed. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a discussion that we wanted to have because I am joined by Mr. Finn. How you doing, Finn?
Hey, I'm good.
We put in, between the two of us, I would imagine, thankfully, because we did have access to the Shadowlands beta, about 3 months worth of work in choosing our characters and made a series of videos on it, and it's all up in the arse.
Yes.
Yeah. And it's not just us, and not making this. We're not making this video because it's just, hey, me and Finn might not be committing to the choices we made through the series and wasted your time. This is widespread. Like, people are like, I don't know. I just don't know. And I know many of you have got in contact because you're in the same boat. Like, what are we looking at here? How is this going to work? Certainly, if you're a raider, the team matters, as we all know. What do you think, Finn? Like, this is... Like, I suppose we should start with, what are your potential new main alts that... And I think we're both in the same position, not particularly big fans of.
Yeah, I think one of mine is fairly close to being locked down. I mean, my main is staying the same. We'll start with that one. But then,
same here. I'm still a hunter.
Yeah, I'm still going to be paladin, which I'm happy with. My alt, though... Yeah, rogue is gone. Because rogue is just not very good. And it's been replaced with... I mean, just a class that I don't really like.
Say it. Say the words.
LA Shaman.
Well, let me counter that. So, my DK is gone. Not going to be happening. Still a hunter, and it's... I want to be clear on this. It is extremely likely, and we'll get into the deeper details of how we got here in a moment, but it's extremely likely my hunter will never need to not be in the raid. Mm-hmm. Hunters are looking very, very good, so happy with that choice. But my main alt seems to be de facto falling to the one spec I did not really want to play, and that's Moonkin.
Yeah.
How did we get here? How did we get here? It's hard to talk about, but I guess we should start off with why not the main alts we went with. And for me, for the DK, DK is not a bad choice. And both of us have had meetings with our raid leadership, which is Alex and Loz from Fat Boss. But primarily it's Alex who deals with this. I'm not sure if you dealt with Alex directly, actually, Finn.
Yeah, I did.
Or whether it was the boys themselves. But Alex is, and I always hate saying this, I hate giving them credit. After meeting Alex and Loz, IRL, before I ever played World of Warcraft with them, several times, one turns up in sandals, the other one couldn't give two fucks about anything in the world. They are ridiculously serious when it comes to making sure the team is organized, the raid is happy, the guild is happy. They take it very, very seriously. And part of that, in terms of leadership, and Alex is a great leader, is sometimes he has to ask some shitty things of people, and he tries his best to make sure everybody is happy, primarily. So when we talked about it, it was like, DK looks good, looks solid. But the more we've done raid testing, the more we've had a look at the fights and brought them down, it's like, it's good. Is it ever going to not be your... Are we ever going to take your hunter out to play DK? Maybe at Denathrius, and it's like this, like, maybe in this particular scenario or whatever, but ultimately probably not. So what is good? And I can talk about how I got to mine with the Moonkin, is that recently they've been struggling so hard to get this dance fight correct. I don't even know its real name, the dance fight. That there's a part of that fight where you deal with a ton of ads, Finn, that are unmanageable. They're all over the place. And Starfall just hard counters it.
Yeah, it really does.
And it does. And it might be a case of get a Moonkin ready for that fight, because it's unlikely we'll ever swap the Hunter out, although my Hunter was blasting. But I actually expect MM to get nerfed. Sorry, Hunters, but I do expect that to happen. That we might look to alts to hard counter things. Are you in a similar boat with Ellie Shaman?
Not a specific fight. More, it's just like the opposite of a Rep Paladin, pretty much. Like, that's the closest that I could get to. So Rep Paladin's probably fairly similar to Hunter right now, in that you're probably going to bring one.
This is really awkward, Finn, because my Twitter feed today, and I didn't mean to jump in to interrupt, but my Twitter feed is full of people asking how Finn feels about the fact that Rep Paladin sucks. And yeah. I'm looking at our raid testing of last week. Blizzard is still raid testing of last week, and Rep Pally was good.
Yeah.
And I'm like, where is this information coming from?
I was kind of blasting, considering I don't know how to play it, apparently. Yeah, Ret Paladin's really good. And I think that the most important part is that Holy Paladin's not very good.
That is true. And this is what comes into this decision, right?
Yeah, so 3% DR is kind of useful. So I think you might have a Ret Paladin just for that, even if it wasn't like top tier DPS. But in the testing last week, it was. It was. It was like top melee on Stone Legions just behind Warrior, like doing Mad Cleave. And then on single target on the Dance Boss, it was top. Just behind your MM Hunter, but that's getting nerfed. So, yeah.
I expect so.
Yeah, I think like Paladin's in a really good spot. I think it's really, really strong. The reason I went Ellie Shaman, or like Alex forced me. I'm just kidding. The reason that Ellie Shaman's in there as well is that like, if there's a fight that Ret Paladin is really not good at, it's probably going to be a fight that Ellie is really good at. Just because of how the two specs play. You need stacked cleave for Paladin to be good on AoE, or you're just blasting single target. So you take the opposite of those fights, which is like spread cleave or like multiple adds focus in a single target, and Ellie is the best at those. So,
which is a weird place, right? Because, I mean, I don't know how you feel about this, but Ellie, through our alpha and beta testing, was horrible.
Yeah.
Like, we had Chain Lightning hitting in the hundreds compared to the thousands that other spells were hitting for. It was just... the tuning of the Ellie Shaman was all over the place. In fact, we've seen with the Ellie Shaman, it be changed and updated to a modern style, and then reverted back to its old style because the modern style didn't work. It's undergone so much tuning and messing around with that it's kind of become the sleeper hit, where we've seen several players switching to Ellie Shamans for raid testing, and they've been fantastic. Maybe not Unat fantastic, but quite up there.
Yeah, they're really good. They're really good. They were really good on Stone Legion when we did last testing, just because you drop Earthquakes and you kill everything. It's kind of mad. They seem like really strong right now. They're
super strong.
They're kind of boring, let's be real.
I like them.
I'm not a huge
fan. I've always liked it.
I definitely liked Unat playstyle, where you had to juggle your flame shocks to get like massive damage, but they nerfed the duration of flame shocks, so you can only really have two, sometimes three, but only for a limited amount of time out. That made it less fun to me. But
yeah, it's the turret style is what made it good.
Yeah.
When you've got those flame shocks blasting and you literally are firing so many lava bursts that you can't flame shock in between, or it feels like you can't without wasting lava burst procs. Yeah. That's when Ellie Shaman takes off and flies.
You don't have spare globals. That's where it was super fun. On Unat, it was super fun to play, even though I never played Unat officially. I think the spec itself is like fine. It's passable. I don't think I'll have to play it much. So similar to your Druid, I'm really hoping that I don't have to play my alt that much. And I'm going to do another alt, maybe two other alts for fun.
Well, I think this brings up two things. The first one I want to throw at you is you are in a situation I'm not in, which is you have the melee problem. Mm. You're a melee character. And we've seen over the further testing has gone, melee not be terrible, but certainly drop in terms of what the ranged are capable of. Now more tuning and more balancing has come out. That it's a lot more dangerous now, it feels, for melee. Now, I haven't raid tested as melee since I raid tested on Feral, but am I right in that thinking? Because that's what I'm seeing, is that a lot of the mechanics now are becoming more and more dangerous if you're melee. And a lot more mechanics favor being ranged, because you could continue to damage while being at range. And there's so many mechanics. And we did meme this a little bit during our raid coverage of the new bosses. Run out with debuff. Run out with marker, run out with debuff is on so many fights that a lot of the testing we've done is like, how can we keep melee somewhat in range? Like, we could just drop it maybe 7 yards to the right, and can we get away with that? And the obvious other answer is just don't use too many melee. Range, don't have to worry about that whatsoever. Have you felt that as a player, or am I kind of exaggerating?
On a couple of fights, yeah, for sure. I think Sludgefist is a really good example where being melee felt awful for the entire time, because even as a paladin, I'd pop wings at the start and I wouldn't get the full duration out before I had to run away from the boss, which is just frustrating. So like that stuff
is a DPS check boss.
Yeah, and that is a DPS check boss. But it might be that I'm just popping wings at the wrong time, right? Like, you never know. It might just be that the kill strat is different. What I will say though is that the last two bosses didn't feel that way.
So that'd be Stone Legion,
and when we did Denathrius.
Oh, Denathrius, yeah.
Neither of them felt like you would have a problem with melee. I think the only bit of Denathrius was like you would need enough range to kill the guys on the side in phase two. Mm-hmm. But other than that, melee felt totally fine. Like you can stack the adds in phase one, burst them down AoE without melee having to run out. In Stone Legion, there's one mechanic that you have to run out for. And that's fine.
Yeah.
It's not like a big deal. Yeah. And even then, even when I brought Monk to the test and it was doing well. So yeah, I think some of the earlier bosses, for sure, there's some spicy stuff that might limit melee, but I don't think they'll be the hard ones.
That's good then, because it definitely felt, and again, a lot of the feedback I get is often very exaggerated from people who are watching streams. We don't stream our raid testing, so we kind of go off our own gut feeling here, which is why I wanted your opinion. But like we said, Monk's terrible. Well, it's not. We're not seeing that. X and Y is terrible, isn't it? Not seeing that either. We're seeing different things from our own testing, and it comes down to a lot of cases like we talked about earlier. Shadowlands has so many different systems, configurations of character, I think is a good way of saying it, that it can very quickly swing either way. So you give me a fight on a Marksman Hunter where I can go like trick shots with a trick shot legendary, with volley, with resonating arrow, with explosive shot, and I do obscene amounts of damage.
Yeah.
But there might be another player who's like not playing that exact configuration, and he's like, well, MM's not really popping off here. I'm not seeing those results. So it's this is why the flux is happening, not just here with me and Finn, across our guild and across many other guilds. It's because we're all getting this very different data. We're trying our best to get it right. Now, this touches on something, Finn, which is like, why have we got a main ult in the first place? What's the point? And it's exactly what we just discussed here, is there is really little chance that me or Finn would not be playing Rep Paladin and Hunter. I can't see a scenario where Alex asks me, can you go on your Moonkin, really? But is there a chance? And that's where it comes to with main ults, is because if you're progressing, a lot of people seem to think, oh, gear is what makes the difference. It's often not. Classes actually do hard counter a lot of things, and we've seen that in a number of other occasions. And as people who take the race as one our most fun thing to do, and to have, you know, and to enjoy it, we don't want to be hard stuck. Because I can't express to you, I don't know if you've ever hit it, Finn. My last time I got hard stuck at a boss because of class comp was actually, and the last time we didn't use main alts, we used main alts every time after this, was actually in Cataclysm, where Omnitron Defense System needed a Dispriest. Like, it just needed it. Like, the fight was so much harder without that. And none of us had one. And that was it. We were just hard stuck. We were overcoming a wall that was just there because we didn't have a Dispriest available.
Yeah.
And that's what we're all looking for with main alts, is like, okay, is there some situation that might occur where we get hard stuck, or we're going to have to overcome a massive, massive hill just because I chose Hunter? And that was what I saw with the Council of Blood fight when all those ads came out. I'm like, wow, we can't grip these. We can't taunt these. They're all over this giant room. Moonkin is perfect here, because Moonkin's just star falling and hitting absolutely everything, dotting absolutely everything, as are the Warlocks. We have lots of Warlocks, so that'd be covered. What is shit at this is Hunter. Hunter might pop off on the boss, but dealing with this, and like Finn just said there, we probably want enough range to deal with these. I'm not going to be particularly useful there.
Yeah.
Which is where we then come to the conclusion, well, what is then? What would be the occasion to switch over?
Yeah, true. And I think like the other part for me is like you want to have at least one of every kind of spec just in case something is really strong. Just for no reason. So like, to use an example, my third character is probably going to be Windwalker Monk. We don't have another Windwalker Monk, and Alex and Laws were kind of fine with me doing it because if they end up being mad broken OP, we kind of want one. Like, that's just tends to be the way. So there's definitely like some bosses just need certain things, and there's also the case of like you never know what they're going to buff or tune or fix, I guess.
Yeah. It's kind of the step up in... a lot of people ask me, and I don't know how you feel about this thing, as you've risen through the ranks in WoW, and it's something we probably should have talked about before now, but I haven't. Is the big difference between... What I've found, honestly, is the biggest difference, and this is why main alts are kind of important once you get into the higher end of Mythic, is that the big difference between the players at, like, maybe World 1000 and the players who break into, like, the World Top 500... Often, it comes down to how good your players are at being able to swap to a different class and play it extremely well. And I've seen that be the difference so many times. If we look at our Gahoon kill, we have like three players swap to different classes. Mm-hmm. Even though they progressed all of Uldir on one particular class, when we got to Cahoon, which is the big mountain, it no longer works. We need to swap and rearrange this. And very quickly, Loz and Alex reached out to myself and some other people, like, we need you on this character next week. And everybody can play an alt, right, Finn? Everyone can pick up a character and play it, but you need to be able to play it to, like, a very, very, very good level very quickly. It's not a case of, like, yeah, I have a capped character. I can play it, right? A lot of people can do that but do badly at it. But main alts are such a big way of overcoming the hills that Blizzard sometimes, unintentionally, I don't think they intentionally make these hills, but these hills happen all the time.
Yeah. Yeah, agree.
And that's why main alts are important. That's why you see guilds saying, you know, we need two characters. The reason they're saying that is experience. Another aspect to me and Alex talked about, I don't know whether you had this conversation, is actually, hey, we're probably not going to need you to swap off your hunter. So what main alt can you have which is better for trading other mains?
And then we started
looking at some armor types.
Yeah, we didn't have that. No. Oh, God, not the armor type stuff again. Oh.
Well, you've seen it. I mean, I don't know how you feel about it, that what they've done in the Shadowlands is they've made it so you can't trade. The profession gear is, what, 5 levels below heroic? Mythic plus gear is 5 levels below heroic?
Yeah.
Just to make sure they really try and stop trading, which hasn't happened, by the way. But after talking to some of the players in the endgame guilds, they're like, yeah, it's not a thing.
We'll find a way.
There's always a way, unfortunately. And they've also come up with some interesting ways of getting around it. The players are always adapting. Do you think it annoys Blizzard? Or should Blizzard butt out?
I think that it's sort of past it now. Like, you're not going to fix it. Just give up. Like, stop wasting time, I think, is my opinion on it. It doesn't matter. If 40 people want to do it, it doesn't matter. Who cares?
It's one of those things that I'm not sure, and maybe the audience could educate me on this, but again, I'm kind of in the mood of bouncing things off your brain now, Finn. What does Blizzard have a problem with? Because it's trading loot. All right, so trading loot has been in MMOs forever, since the start of MMOs. You kill a big boss, you trade out all the loot, right? And then we had it go to the point where, oh, well, we're not having master loot anymore. And we're like, well, why? This makes it more annoying. Now we have to trade each other. And then they say, oh, look, that's not what we want you to do either. What we want you to do is you kind of keep whatever you got. But that's against RPG rules forever. If you go back to Chrono Trigger, even the earliest Final Fantasy, swapping your gear around before a major fight was a very normal thing.
Yep.
It takes place in lots and lots of dice games. Is the same thing as modifying your character to meet the challenge ahead.
I've been replaying Final Fantasies, the earlier ones, and out of interest, they actually like pause the game and give you a chance to swap your gear around before boss fights. Like it's not even a like part of the game that you have to like sly in. No, they give you the option right before the boss fight starts.
It's always been a thing, and that's why I found it very bizarre. Because obviously this situation came up with the Covenants as well. Well, classic RPGs never allowed you to do that kind of stuff. I'm like, which ones? Yeah. Like I put it out on Twitter. I was like, hey guys, can you guys name an RPG where you weren't really able to do this? And the best example the guys came up with where you weren't kind of locked in was things like Star Wars, where you could either go Sith or Jedi. Now, I would say in a single player game, one, and a Star Wars game based on whether or not you can become a Jedi or a Sith as its main selling point, yeah, okay, that makes sense. But being a Sith or a Jedi is kind of a distinct difference between each other.
Isn't that like Horde Alliance? Seeing that here.
Yes, exactly. Which is like, I understand that, but that was like the best example they came up with was those. And there are others that do try and lock you in some form or another. But when it comes to loot swapping, what do you... Because we have seen multiple times now, whether Blizzard says it or not, or puts out a post, they going out of their way to intervene in how players control items in the game. And every single time, the players find a way around it. Or, like we saw at the beginning of BFA, you remember when Azerite armor was completely untradeable?
Yeah.
At the launch of BFA, you could not trade Azerite armor regardless of any circumstance. It was untradeable.
Yeah. That was so dumb. Anyway.
It was insane. But that's the kind of mentality that the guys have right now at Blizzard, is to intervene and say, no, we don't want you doing that. And I can't think of a single reason why. And certainly when we talk about raid loot trading, it's heroic level gear. It's not end game. Like, it's not the best stuff in the game that people are freely just throwing around. What is their problem with it, Finn? Do you have an answer? Because I've been trying to figure it out for years.
Do you know what it is? I think it's a way for them to try and make content harder. I think that's all they've got, to be honest. I think they really struggle to make bosses hard. and their best way of doing that is like by making you weaker. So for some time now, like things are generally weaker than they were in, say, Legion. Like your character progression's like much weaker. And I think they saw that as a particularly bad point. And then in BFA and now Shadowlands, they're like trying to rein you in a little bit. And I think trading's a part of that. Trading's just a part of like how do we make an overall raid composition weaker? I think we don't.
Who do you think they're targeting though? Because we obviously complain about it quite a lot. Honestly. Well, I mean, I'm just saying this can't be targeting Mythic Raiders. It's already hard enough, right? Mythic raiding is hard enough. I will stand by that. I would even go as far as, even though it would make my game experience worse, that Mythic raiding is too hard in a lot of cases for most people who play World of Warcraft. It's really, really ridiculously bleeding edge. It is. So are they targeting the heroic raiders with this? Or, and this is something I did think of, are there just an absolutely large swell of people, and we would never have the data on this, so I'm certainly not speaking for those people or any of that nonsense. I'm just supposing ideas that make sense and fit the theory, that get heroic geared and then they just stop.
Yeah. I don't know.
And that's something they're trying to curb. It's like people get to like heroic item level, they're absolutely not interested in going towards mythic item level, so we want to slow it down in the heroic period of time. Not in the mythic period of time, because it's annoying, but we always find ways around it. And as do the heroic guilds who follow suit, but are they trying to affect the large swell of players that are in heroic tier so that you can't... It's hard to say, because eventually you can trade, you know, after a few weeks. It's really only impacts the launch of the game.
Yeah, it does. Yeah, it only impacts the first, like, 2 or 3 weeks. Which is the fun part for me. That's my favorite part of the game.
I love it, because it was a big counter. When I said, when the loot trading thing came in, people were like, oh, thank God, I don't need to grind M+. And I was like, I really like doing that. As somebody at launch who can play all day, because I'm lucky and fortunate enough to do it as part of my job, I love doing that. And then the guys who come home from work who can't do that, and they want to do that, but they can't, I could trade them loot and get them caught up, you know, as part of the team.
Yeah.
I love that. I get that first rush of getting gear that I know that regardless of how I play is useless to me in like 3 weeks' time.
Yeah.
Right? And I know that. But I get that initial rush and I get to help out my friends. And it's also, I like trading gear.
It's also
weird. I like it.
Yeah, I mean, that's same. But it's also when the content feels kind of hard. You know, like the initial M0 runs are difficult. You actually have to do stuff. I remember even in BFA, they were kind of difficult.
King's Rest was a nightmare in M0.
King's Rest was really hard, yeah. And even, I remember Atal Dazar just like on my Warlock. Doing a Warlock M0 first week was awful, but like that, I remember being in there for like an hour at one point trying to do an M0. So
yeah.
So yeah, I really enjoy it because like everyone's low geared. You can't just smash through dungeons like you can now. I mean, we did a 17 last week with Pugs and it was the easiest key I've done in months. So like
yes.
So yeah, like it's nice when the content's like fresh. And then taking away trading is just, it always feels bad. I remember at the beginning of BFA, I had a dagger, like an M0 dagger, and I got a wand drop and I couldn't trade it. And it felt awful. It felt so bad for me and the guy I could have given it to. So it just like, I don't get it. I don't understand why it's not a thing.
Which then brings us back around to the topic of this conversation, which is the main alt scenario on what characters we're going to play.
Yeah.
Because this is how we think. And some of you might be like, you guys are really overthinking this, like, what the fuck? But it really matters to how we play the game is to not run into these kinds of situations and to try and plan now to work around it, which sometimes ends up in us going, okay, in a worst case scenario, what could happen here? And like for me, it's like, okay, we could get to Council of Blood, we could smash through the raid.
Yeah,
it's got to be near Christmas, so maybe it's an Emerald Nightmare type scenario, yet we get stuck on this boss because these ads are just melting us and we have no real way of hard countering that and making it less of an issue. So maybe I think about that scenario. I probably will, in 90% of all situations I think of, I'm probably going to stay on my Hunter and everything's going to be fine. But it's thinking about that. And then we think about what we just talked about then. It's like, well, maybe actually a lot of our main alts are leather wearers. So it might be a good idea if you make a main alt that's a leather wearer, even if we're not going to use it, to help furnish the people we might use it on.
Yeah, true.
And that's how we look at it here. And hopefully we've kind of clarified how main alts are important. at least as you get higher up in yeah. the tier.
Like, I think my shaman will just end up feeding your hunter gear. That's the plan, anyway.
Well, I could say, like, my mage, my mage was my main alt throughout BFA. We used it twice, I think.
Yeah, once or twice, I think. Yeah.
Yeah, something like that. I used it once or twice. I exalted on Najatar on that thing. I mean, it was fully ready to go. And my priest was the same, but you know me. And I remember I got a lot of stick in the guild for this. As soon as progress was done, I was like, well, that's meet up.
Yeah.
And I'm not playing my main alts.
We used my shaman once, but I think I have like 8 characters that I've played over the last couple of months. Just because I'm the opposite of you. I'm like, once raid's killed, I just play whatever I like. I was playing Survival Hunter for a bit. So
I would have done if it wasn't for like Azerite and Essence.
Yeah, that's true.
Like,
it was a bit of a grind.
Some people did have a go at me about it. They were like, you really should have a main alt ready. I'm like, we're finished. And we've got so many players that it doesn't, we're not short on people either. So it was like, if we were lacking a spot, of course I would have sorted that character out. If like, you know, we've not got 5 people waiting on the bench to get into the raid. Then yeah, sure, obviously.
Yeah.
But we weren't in that scenario at all. We started recruiting for Shadowlands. We had 10 plus people extra, and it's like it's not fun. I don't want to grind as right power, and I don't want to do fucking X and Y. So I'm not going to do it.
Oh god.
I did my benthic on my priest. I did all the stuff in case we needed it. It was like fully up to date during progress, and then the moment progress stopped, I was like, done.
Yeah.
Finished. Game over. Nazoth dead. Fair. I'm out. Peace. That's how I looked at it. I was like, okay, this is not fun. Maintaining a character isn't interesting. This is obviously pre all the essence catch-up system and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So I didn't do it there. But it does bring us to a good point, is we're talking about mains and main alts. These are the characters that we should probably explain this at the beginning, but these are the characters that we kind of agree with the guild.
Yeah.
This is going to be my main character. When I show up on raid night, I'm going to be on this character. And I have this character that I commit to the guild. I will keep this ready for whenever we need it. So if you go if Alex goes mid raid, Finn, I need you on your shaman. You can go. Yep, it's there.
Yeah, it essentially needs to be as ready as my main, mm-hmm. which is fine. Doing 2 is not bad.
I actually think it's super easy. That's why I was leading this conversation.
I've stupidly said I'm going to do 3. I think I'm actually going to do 4, but
I think I'm going to do more. I'm excited.
Don't tell Alex I'm going to do 4. I think like 3 officially is my cap right now, because I don't know, like things like the maw, I still don't know how much I need to farm that, for example.
So it could be every day.
If it's every day, like a proper grind, then I'll just do 2 and my monk will be okay. And if it's mad broken, I'll just spam it for a week or something. But yeah, I think like 2 is fairly simple in Shadowlands actually, much, much easier than it was in BFA. And I'll probably do a monk, and then I'm thinking about my 4th. I'm torn between a few classes, but I'm just going to pick whatever's fun.
I'm going to play everything. Not to the point of it being raid ready.
Yeah, eventually.
There's not a class in Shadowlands I don't enjoy in some way. There isn't. There's not one.
Yeah.
It's so far removed from BFA, and I dreaded the day. Because we just did the Choosing a Main series like a month or so ago. I dreaded making that series for BFA, because I was like, I don't like anything. They are all slow. They're all step backs from Legion. Then every time I want to do something fun, that option has now disappeared, because it used to be there. Now it's gone. And I don't like anything. I can't decide anything I'm particularly interested in. This time around, though, I'm like, there's nothing I haven't really enjoyed. Like when we were doing, and it's a real sadness, a lot of people keep asking us to do the Torghast races again.
I know, yeah.
We can't. The introduction to that stuff that's now in the game is enormous, guys.
And it's only 6 floors once you get most of it unlocked anyway, which is rubbish. It's a crap race.
It's a crap race. We would have to do, because to unlock the Twisting Corridors, it actually takes about 3 hours.
Yeah.
And then we can't even mix up Torghast. We can't even mix up Covenant abilities, because you'd have to commit your character to it. So when we did the Torghast races, we could literally log in and make a new character and be ready to go in the Torghast Twisting Corridors run in 5 minutes. It was so fun.
We can do it on the Torghast test round just now, but it's only 6 floors. And literally,
it's only 6 floors.
Literally, so you can get a power in the first floor that will define your run, which was less so in the 18 floors, right? So,
With the 18, you had that opportunity. Like maybe at floor 7, I get something that allows
me
to catch
up. Make a little
up,
comeback, you know. But you can't,
and you can make
6.
Combos. Combos take a lot of floors to get going.
True.
On live, we'll be able to do that, I think. We'll be still locked into Covenants, but we'll be able to do that. But this coming back to it, what we were just about to say is that I did the video last week, or in fact 2 days ago, which was There's not a great deal of player power stuff to do.
Yeah.
In the Shadowlands, which is great.
Love that. It's
awesome.
Means I don't
and
have to do
it. Means, yeah, that's what it means to do many characters, like me and Finn are talking about, is it's really easy to do. I'm not going to do the campaign on them all, besides getting the renown. I'm not going to do the weekly event on them all or anything like that. But in terms of having a character that can log in and go to a dungeon and go to a raid, I'll do a Torghast run. No problem.
Yeah.
So easy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm super excited for that. So I hope that clears it up, and I hope that gives you some insight into what's been happening, because me and Finn were like, I'm going to be a hunter. I'm going to be a DK. I think you were Rhett and Rogue.
Rhett and Rogue, Rhett and Monk? Rogue is gone. That's dead.
Why is the Rogue gone? Is it just because of the Covenant abilities?
The Covenant abilities are trash. No, I love the Necrolord one. Not because it was broken, but because it was actually fun to use. And instead of like balancing it, they just destroyed it, which sort of killed my soul a little bit. And I really liked Sub. And Sub is still kind of fun. But I just don't think it's going to ever be used instead of my Paladin. If I'm going to play melee, I'll be on my Paladin.
Yeah.
So there's no point in having it.
No, when it comes to a main alt, your goal is to support the raid in some way. And
support your main. So like the real idea for me is that I don't want to be on the bench particularly. So if my main is bad, I want my alt to be good. So that's like the combo for me. It's like they both help support the raid, and they both help support me play the game, which is kind of nice.
Mm-hmm. That is the whole point of it. So what people have been asking, like, how do you choose a main alt? It's you have to think of the scenario, which is like the two things, and I guess that's what we've covered here today and the thought process behind it. One, is my main going to be useless somewhere? You don't need to have raid tested to do this, by the way. I know people are like, yeah, but you've played it and seen. You can check the streams, you can check the videos, there's preview videos everywhere. Is there a fight where my class is likely to be a problem? Ergo, I'm going to end up on the bench. Or my guild, if we don't have people on the bench ready to come in, our guild kind of hits a hard stop. And we just kind of have to overcome a problem that maybe you're creating or would be solved if you would have gone like Finn's done. If we're not going to use my Rep Paladin, we're probably going to use something that's ranged. It's okay. So it's not another melee class. That's why the Rogue's out. And we probably want something that's going to do... What fights is this likely to happen on? Well, it's probably something that's probably involving AoE, as a lot of fights do. So maybe I'm going to go Ellie Shaman, because that's really strong in that environment.
Yeah.
The same I've done. It's probably spread. If what am I not going to use my Hunter, which is awesome at gathered cleave and single target? Probably when something's like needs AoEing that's all over the place. Well, Moonkin fits that role. So that's where I'm probably going to do it.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah.
We're going to change our minds again in a week, aren't we?
Probably. Probably. They'll all get nerfed on Wednesday.
Oh my God. I'm so sorry, guys. I guess we should say, like, I am sorry that we've not been able to do the proper class looks and overviews. We've done all the work.
Yes,
but we can't trust a goddamn thing that Blizzard's doing. That's why everyone's in flux. It's part of the reason this balancing's all over the place as well. Mm. We just don't know what... Well, in fact, they did no update this week. It might actually come tonight. If they don't do it on a Wednesday, it generally comes on a Thursday.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I'm dreading it.
It's always fun.
It's gotta be such
it just means I need to update the Lego spreadsheet again. I can't wait.
Let's all right. Thank you very much, guys. We'll see you again. Bye-bye.
Bye.